Welcome learners, I am Divyanath. Today we are going to discuss about Module 4, Lesson 9, Mazes of Dispersion, Part 4. In this module, we are going to discuss about the concept of standard deviation, calculation of standard deviation by actual mean method, assumed mean method, direct method, and step deviation method mean. Then we are going to discuss about concept of coefficient of variation. So, students, let's talk about standard deviation. Now, very first, why we are going to compute standard deviation in the previous class, we have talked about so much about mean deviation. Now, in mean deviation, what has happened here? That in that case, we have taken the modulus, we have ignored the signs, right? But in case of standard deviation, we do not ignore the signs. That means we consider the deviation properly, and hence it is a better measure than the mean deviation. So we can say that after all, range, quartile deviation, mean deviation, we can say that standard deviation is the best measure of dispersion. And why is it so? Let's see. As we know, standard deviation is the most important and commonly used measure of dispersion. It measures the absolute dispersion or variability of distribution. Standard deviation is the positive square root of the mean of the squared deviation of observations from their mean, and it is denoted by the sign standard S dot D dot, or we can see the sign of standard deviation. Now, students, we have just learned that in case of standard deviation, we do not ignore the deviation sign over here, very first, and we are going to calculate standard deviation from mean only. And as we know, mean is based on all the observation. So that is why we are saying standard deviation is the best measure of dispersion. Now, let's see what we talk about standard deviation calculation. When we talk about calculation of standard deviation, we can calculate standard deviation from individual series, we can calculate standard deviation from discrete series, we can calculate standard deviation from frequency distribution. Now, when we talk about standard deviation in case of individual series, there are four methods by which we can compute standard deviation. Let's see. The very first is actual mean method, the second is assumed mean method, the third is direct method, and the last one is step deviation method. So, students, we are going to calculate standard deviation in case of individual series by all the four methods, right? Let's see with the help of an example. But before that, see what are the steps. The steps in actual mean method, the very first step would be we are going to find out the mean value, right? Once we know the value of mean, the step second would be obtain the deviation of each item from mean. Once we have calculated deviation of each item from mean, the next step would be we have to square the deviation, and the next step is we have to sum the deviations taken from mean. Once we have identified this value, we can apply the formula for the standard deviation. Now, over here, the standard deviation would be under root sum of x minus x bar square upon n. Now, when we take deviations of x from mean, then we can also write small x for that. So, the other formula for that, we can say under root sum of small x square upon n. Now, let's take an example to understand it. Calculate standard deviation from actual mean method from the following information. The serial number is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The marks is 12, 8, 17, 13, 15, 9, 18, 11, 6 and 1. Now, do you remember the first step was we have to calculate mean, the very first step. So, over here you can see the first step we have done is that we have computed the mean. Mean is equal to sum of x upon n. So, that means I have to sum up the item values. That means 12 plus 8 plus 17 plus 13 and so on will give the value of 110. The total number of observation is 10. 110 divided by 10 gives you 11 marks. So I know the mean is 11. Now the very first step after this is we have to take deviations from mean. And mind it, here we are not going to ignore the sign as we have done in case of median in the previous class. Here we are considering the signs, right? That means 12 minus 11. 1, 8 minus 11 minus 3. Over here we are considering the signs. Once we have taken the deviations like this, then the next step is we have to square the deviations from mean. 1 square comes to 1, minus 3 square comes to 9, 6 square comes to 36, and so on. Likewise, we are going to compute for all the number of observations. And the next step is we have to sum up the deviations taken from mean. That comes to sum of smalls x square. That comes to 244. Now we have got sum of small x square is equals to 244. Number of observation we have 10. We can straightforward apply the formula. Over here you can see the formula is written. We have just put the values. Small x square is 244, n is 10. Under root 244 divided by 10 gives you under root 24.4, comes to 4.94 marks. So students, over here we have learned how to calculate standard deviation by actual mean method in case of individual series. Now let's talk about the next method. The next method is assume mean method. So let's see first what are the steps, and then we are going to take an example to solve it. So steps in assume mean method are, very first, over here we are not going to calculate mean, we are first going to find out A. Then the second step, obtain the deviations of each item from A, that is over here we are going to find x minus A, that comes to dx, right? Then square each deviations, dx square. Then obtain the sum of dx square, right? And then we are going to apply the formula for standard deviation. That comes to under root sum of dx square upon n minus sum of dx upon n whole square, and that too all in under root, right? Now once we know the steps, we know the formula, we can take an example and see. Now the question says calculate standard deviation from assume mean method from the following information. The question is there. The very first step would be we have to identify the A. Over here we can see the A is 20 and we have taken it from the marks. Step 1, deviation taken from assume mean, that is dx. That means 8 minus 20 comes to minus 12, 10 minus 20 comes to minus 10. Over here students, keep in mind we are not ignoring the signs as we have done in mean deviations, and likewise we have calculated for the whole. After this, the next step is I have to square it up. 12 minus 12 square comes to 144, minus 10 square comes to 100, and so on. Now we are going to sum up sum of dx square, that is 420, as we know it is required in the formula, and likewise we are going to sum up sum of dx, that means the deviation taken from assumed mean has also been summed up. That comes to sum of dx is equals to minus 30. Now we know the values, we can apply the formula. The formula over here is under root sum of dx square upon n minus sum of dx upon n whole square, all in under root. We have put the values 420 divided by 10 minus minus 30 divided by 10 whole square. That comes to 42 minus minus 3 square, that comes to under root 33, and in the end we have solved the under root and we have got the answer 5.74. Now students, in this we have just learned how to calculate standard deviation in case of individual series by assume mean method. After this we are going to discuss how we can calculate standard deviation by direct method in individual series. Let's see the steps first, how we are going to calculate standard deviation by direct method. Very first, we are going to identify the mean. That means we have to calculate the mean, right? Once we have calculated the mean, square of each item will be also done. That means x individual will be squared. Then obtain the sum. That means sum of x square, capital X square, that means item square is also there. Fine. You can see in the formula the standard deviation is telling sum of capital X square, that means item square, divided by number of observation minus sum of X upon N, that is mean, by whole square. That means we are going to square it also. So, this is the formula for calculating standard deviation by direct method, right? Let's take an example. In this question, it states calculate standard deviation from direct method from the following information, right? Serial number is given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, marks is given 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. Now, the next step is we have to sum up this X square, capital X square. That capital X square comes to 5500. We have also done the sum of X, that is 150, and the total number of observations comes to 5. Once we have this information, we can apply the formula. Standard deviation is equals to under root sum of capital X square upon N minus sum of X upon N whole square. Now, after this, we are going to put up the values. That comes to under root 5500 divided by 5 minus 150 divided by 5 whole square. When we solve it, it comes to under root 200, and when we solve it, it comes to 14.14 marks. So, students, we have learned how to calculate standard deviation by direct method in case of individual series. Now, after this, we are going to learn how to calculate standard deviation by step deviation method in case of individual series, right? Now, let's see the steps first, and then we are going to take an example to solve it. The first step is that we have to find out A, that means assumed average. Then we are going to take deviations from the item values from the assumed mean, right? Then deviations are divided by the sum common factor C. So, dx divided by C gives us dx dash. The next step would be we have to obtain the sum of dx dash, right? Once I have obtained the sum of dx, then the next step is I have to find out dx square also. And dx square means first I am identifying the value dx dash, then I am squaring them, and then I am adding them. That is the fifth step. Square each deviation and then sum total of. So, we have found sum dx dash square. Once we have identified sum of dx dash, we have identified sum of dx dash square, then we are going to write the formula, and the formula says standard deviation is equals to under root sum of dx dash square upon n minus in brackets sum of dx upon n, which is dash square into c. Now, this c is a common factor. So, it will be out of the under root sign. So, students often make mistake over here. So, when you write this formula, keep in mind that into c will be out of the under root. Let's take an example and understand it better, right? So, in this particular question, it is telling calculate standard deviation from step deviation method from the following information. Serial number is there, monthly income is there. The very first, I have to identify A. So, we have identified A as 1000, right? So, dx, the very first column, x minus A, 500 minus 1000 minus 500 and so on. Then, in this dx, I am able to see that the whole series can be divided by common factor, that is 100, right? So, C has been taken as 100, dx dash is being calculated as dx divided by C, that means minus 500 divided by 100 comes to minus 5, minus 300 divided by 100 comes to minus 3, and when we sum it up, it comes to 0. Then the next is dx dash square, we are going to square it, so minus 5 into minus 5 comes to 25, minus 3 into minus 3 comes to 9 and so on. We get the value of sum of dx dash square is equals to 68. Total number of observation is 5. Once we have this formula, we can easily apply the formula. Let's see. Now, over here, under root sum of dx dash square upon n minus sum of dx dash upon n in brackets square into c. The formula may, in this particular formula, the c is out of under root. Putting the values, we get 68 divided by 5 minus 0 divided by 5 square under root into 100. That comes to under root 13.6 into 100. That comes to 368.78 marks. So, students, we have learned how to calculate particularly standard deviation by step deviation method in case of individual series. Now students, up till now we have done standard deviation by four methods in case of individual series. Now we are going to discuss and calculate standard deviation in case of discrete series, right? In this particular, we are going to see that there are three methods to compute standard deviation. In case of discrete series, we are first going to calculate it by actual mean method. Then we are going to calculate it by assumed mean method. And then we are going to calculate by step deviation method. So let's see what are the steps by the first method first, and then we are going to take an example and then we are going to solve it. So the steps in actual mean method in case of discrete series is, very first we have to obtain mean. Now note it, over here the mean formula changes, right, because it's a discrete series. Then we have to obtain the deviation of each item from mean, x minus x bar. Now we are going to square it, right, and then take its sum, and then we are going to multiply with this corresponding frequency, and after that we are going to add it up. So we get sum of f small x square, right? Now let's see the formula. Standard deviation is under root sum of f into small x square upon n, or we can elaborate the formula as seen. It is under root sum of f in brackets x minus x bar square upon n, right? So let's take an example to understand it better. In this particular example, it is being told to calculate standard deviation from actual mean method. So over here, very first step would be, we have to calculate mean, right? So let's see. The mean formula changes over here because it's not an individual series, it's in a discrete series. We have got f over here, sum of fx upon n. N over here is sum of frequency. So very first step is, I have to first find out the column fx. That means I have to multiply frequencies with the item values 1 into 4, 2 into 6, 3 into 8, and we get the value, so on, right? And the value comes to 170. The sum of fx comes to 170. Number of observation comes to 17. We put the values and we get the mean value as 10. The next step, deviations taken from mean, right? So over here, the next step is deviations taken from mean. So students, over here we now know the values which can be applied to the formula, right? Sum of fx square is also there, 160. How we have obtained? We have identified x first, that is x minus x bar. Then we have squared it, and then we have multiplied x square with the corresponding frequencies, and we have got sum of fx square is equals to 160. Once we know these value, we can easily apply to the formula. We know standard deviation is equals to under root sum of f small x square upon n. We put the values 160 divided by 17, that comes to under root 9.41. We solve it, we get 3.07. So students, we have just learned how to calculate standard deviation by actual mean method in case of discrete series. Now let's discuss about assumed mean method. What are the steps first? Very first step, again I have to find out A from the given data. Then in the particular case, I have to obtain deviations from each item from A. That means I have to calculate dx. Then I will multiply with its corresponding frequency and sum it up. That comes to sum of f dx. Then what I am going to do? I am going to square dx first. Dx square. Then I will multiply with its corresponding frequency and add it up. It comes to sum of f dx square. Then I multiply or apply the particular formula for it. That comes to standard deviation is equals to under root sum of f dx square upon n minus in the bracket sum of f dx upon n whole square. Now once I know the formula, I can easily use an example to understand it, right? In this particular question, we say calculate standard deviation from assumed mean method from the following information. The size of items are given, I have to identify A first. The first step is, I will identify A. Over here, A is 5. First step, x minus a is dx, right? So x is 1 and a is 5. 1 minus 5 comes to minus 4 and so on. The next step is, I have to square this dx. That comes to minus 4 into minus 4, 16, and so on. Then what I'm going to do is that I'm going to multiply f with dx, and I'm going to also multiply f with dx square. When I multiply f with dx, I get sum of f dx is equals to minus 25, and when I multiply f with dx square and sum it up, I get 435. Once I know these values, I can apply the formula. Let's see. We have applied the formula, under root sum of f dx square upon n minus sum of f dx upon n square. Now we apply the formula, we put the values, 435 divided by 100 minus in bracket 25 divided by 100 square, and this is all in under root, that comes to under root 4.29, and we get 2.07. So students, over here we have learned how to calculate standard deviation in case of discrete series by assumed mean method. Now we can discuss about step deviation method, right? Let's see the steps first. Very first step is I have to identify A, then I have to take deviations from A, that is dx. Now the main part over here starts. I have to divide this dx by the common division of the series, right? I will get dx dash. Now I will multiply with it frequencies corresponding and sum it up, that comes to sum of f dx dash. Then I will square this dx dash and multiply with this corresponding frequency and add it up. It comes to sum of f dx dash square, right? And then I'm going to apply the formula. Now when I'm going to apply the formula, again I have to keep in mind that the C is out of under root over here. C means common divisors. Under root f dx dash square upon n minus in brackets f dx dash upon n whole square. It is all in under root and multiplied with the common factor C, right? Let's take an example to understand it better. Over here you can see we have been asked to calculate standard deviation method, to do it by step deviation method, right? The sizes have been given 500, 700, 1000, 1500, 1300, and their respective frequencies have been given. Students, over here the first step is to identify A. We have identified A as 1000. Then the step is identifying dx, that means x minus A, 500 minus 1000 minus 500, and likewise. Then over here we have to identify that this particular data can be divided by some common factor. Yes, it is over here, C is equals to 100, right? So over here minus 5 minus 3, 0, 5 and 3, that is how we have calculated dx dash dx divided by C. Then we have squared it up, minus 5 into minus 5, that comes to 25, that comes to 9, and so on. Now the next steps, I have to multiply dx dash with its corresponding frequency and add it up, I get it to. In the next step, I am going to multiply dx dash square with its corresponding frequency and I get 102. Now once I have got all this information, I can easily apply the formula and put the values. You know the formula, we have just put under root 102 by 10 minus in small brackets 2 by 10 square into 100. This 100 is out of the under root. When we solve it, we get under root 6.2 into 100 and then 2.49 into 100, and hence comes 249. So students, we have learned up till now how to calculate standard deviation by all the three methods, right? In case of discrete series. Now we are going to calculate standard deviation in case of frequency distribution. And let's see how many methods are there to compute standard deviation. Again, there are three methods: actual mean method, assumed mean method, and step deviation method. Let's see the steps first. The step first for actual mean method remains the same, mean, but the computation changes, right? Then the deviations taken from mean will be taken. Over here we will first convert the class intervals into mid values. We have to keep in this mind. Then we are going to square the deviation, that comes to sum of small x square, and then we are going to multiply with this corresponding frequency, we will get sum of f x square. Students, please note over here, the formula remains same for the discrete series and for the frequency distribution, but steps changes, right? We are using the same formula. You can see over there, standard deviation under root sum of f x square upon n. Let's see an example and identify the changes in the steps. In this question, the size of the items have been given and the frequency is being given. So in this particular question, we have to calculate standard deviation from actual mean method, right? Now after this, the very first step, we have to find the mid value, 0 to 2 mid value, lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2 comes to 1 and so on. The frequencies have been given. First step, for mean, the formula says sum of fm upon n. N means total number of observation, that is sum of frequencies, right? Fm we have done, f and m we have multiplied, total comes to 156. N means total of frequency comes to 24. Apply the formula, put the value, we get 6.5. Then the next step is deviations taken from mean. That means 1 minus 6.5 comes to minus 5.5. We are ignoring the signs or we are taking the signs. Over here, we are taking the signs because it's a case of standard deviations. So we cannot ignore over here the signs. So minus 5.5 and so on. Then this small x is squared. Right, and then we have multiplied with its corresponding frequency and the sum comes small fx square comes to 258. Once we know this information, I can easily calculate the standard deviation. Let's see over here. Standard deviation is equal to under root sum of fx square upon n. We put the values under root 160 divided by 17, that comes to under root 9.41 and we get the answer 3.07. So, in this case, we have learned how to calculate standard deviation by actual mean method in case of frequency distribution. One more step is added at least. Mid values have been calculated over here, right? After this, we are going to discuss the steps in assume mean method. Again, the step remains same. I have to identify A, but over here, mid values will be also obtained. And the deviations taken from assume mean would be from mid values. That's all the difference. Then we are going to sum it up, sum of f dx, we have found it at dx, we are going to multiply with this corresponding frequency and then we are going to sum it up. That comes to sum of f dx, right? Dx square is also done and then it is multiplied with this corresponding frequency and then sum it up is done. And then in the last, we have to apply the formula, under root f dx square upon n minus sum of f dx upon n whole square, that is all in under root. Let's take in question to understand it better. In this particular question, size of items have been given to you, frequencies have been given to you. Let's find out the standard deviation by assume mean method. Very first step, I have to identify A. A is 5, mid values have been taken, F is there. That means dx will be computed over here. Dx is equals to m minus A. M is 1, dx is 5. 1 minus 5 comes to minus 4. Over here, we are also not ignoring the signs because it's a standard deviation. Then we have multiplied f into dx, we get the value 36. Then we are going to do squaring of dx, dx square. Then we are going to multiply with its corresponding frequencies. And sum is sum of f dx square, that comes to 312. Once I know all this information, I know it's all in the formula. Apply the formula now. We have applied the formula under root sum of f dx square upon n minus in brackets sum of f dx upon n whole square. This is all in under root. Put the values 312 by 24 minus in small brackets 36 divided by 24 square. This is all in under root. We get under root 13 minus 2.25 and get 3.28. So students, we have applied the formula for standard deviation by assume mean method in case of frequency distribution. Now the last method, steps in step deviation method. Again, first step A, then the next step would be I have to identify the dx, then dx dash, then how we are going to find out dx dash, we are going to calculate is dx divided by c. Then f into dx dash and sum it up. Then dx dash square will be done, multiplied with its frequency and added up. In the last, we are just going to apply the formula. Now over here, we can see the discrete series formula remains the same for the frequency distribution, right? Under root sum of f dx dash square upon n minus in small brackets sum of f dx dash upon n whole square. This is all in under root, but into C is not in under root. So we now know the formula for standard deviation. We can take an example to understand it better. Now in this particular case, you can see the size of the items have been given as 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30 and so on. And the frequencies have been given. The very first step, I have to first convert it into mid values, right? And then we have to find the deviations. So over here we can see that deviations have been dx, and we have taken the mid values, though we have not written over here because there were too many columns. We can find the mid values. That comes to how much? 0 plus 10 by 2, 5, 10 plus 2 comes to 15. We have taken the deviation A as 35. So we have subtracted it, deviations taken from assumed mean. Once we have calculated dx, then we can calculate dx dash, because we can see dx, the whole series can be divided by common factor, that could be 10, right? Then dx dash square. In the last, we are going to multiply frequencies with dx dash and multiply the frequencies with dx dash square. And what we get? Sum of f dx dash, we get 61. Sum of f dx dash square, we get 369. The frequencies total give us 139. We can easily apply the formula now. In the formulas, we have no 369 divided by 139 minus in small bracket 61 divided by 139 square, and this is all in under root into 10. Now, when we solve it further, we get under root 2.462 into 10, and we get 15.69 value. Now, since we have discussed and calculated standard deviation in case of frequency distribution by three methods, actual mean method, assumed mean method, and step deviation method, the last of this is that we have to find out the coefficient of variation. Now, the coefficient of variation plays an important role. When we have to compare two or more distribution, we use coefficient of variation. Now, what is coefficient of variation? It is the relative measure of dispersion which is used for comparison of variability of two or more distributions. Once we get higher coefficient of variations, it suggests that there is greater degree of variability and less of stability, right? On the other hand, lower value of coefficient of variation suggests lower degree of variability and higher degree of stability, uniformity, homogeneity, and consistency. Students, let's see how we can calculate coefficient of variation. Coefficient of variation can be calculated with the help of mean and standard deviation. So, if the standard deviation is given to us and mean is given to us, we can just apply the formula standard deviation divided by mean into 100. Over here, you can see that example is there. Standard deviation is 41.83, mean is 50. So, coefficient of variation is 41.83 divided by 50 into 100. That comes to 83.66. Suppose there are two firms, and if one of the firms coefficient of variation is coming more, we can comment that in this particular firm there is more variation, more instability, right? So this was the use of coefficient of variation. So students, I hope you have learned a lot. Let's recall the main concepts. In this class, we have learned how to calculate standard deviation in case of individual series by four methods, that is actual mean method, assumed mean method, direct mean method, and step deviation method. In case of discrete series, we have used only three methods. Very first, actual mean method, assumed mean method, and step deviation method. Students, note over here, the formula is going to remain the same for frequency distribution. Only the calculation of mean and one more step, one more column will be added, that is mid value, right? So, we can see the formula remains still the same in case of frequency distribution. All the three methods, actual mean method, assumed mean method, and step deviation method. After this, we have discussed about coefficient of variation. We now know it can be calculated easily once we know the value of standard deviation and mean. And we know it is used for the comparison of variability of two or more distributions. Students, I hope this class is better understood by you. You have been known how to calculate standard deviation. We have also learned that it is the best measure of dispersion, and we now know standard deviation can be calculated in case of different series by different methods. Thank you.